Hi, Angela from Uranda here. In this video of the beginner tutorial series, we are gonna talk about volumetrics. If you like to set up this scene from start to finish, check out the other videos. Let me show you where you can download the trial, request a Uranda trial license, download Uranda for Cinema 4D, run the installer. If you need help installing Uranda, check out our trial installation video guide to take a look at the installation manual. Then open the folder according to your Cinema 4D version. Now copy the Uranda folder, go to your preference folder, plugins folder, and paste. Restart Cinema and open Uranda Studio. Click on Manage License and copy the key that you received by email and click on Activate. You can download the scene and all the other in-between steps, just head to our website, downloads, examples and assets and scroll down. In the zip you can also find the final dragon scene, which I'm using right now. As always, make sure to use the Uranda layout and let's start right away. Head over to the render settings, Uranda, volumetrics, and if it isn't already enabled, you can turn them on here. Now create a volume object just by clicking on this cloud icon. If you don't use the layout, you can find it here under extensions, Uranda, Uranda volume. Be sure to have a light source in your scene. I won't use my existing lights for the volumetrics, so I'm gonna switch this off. Duplicate the backlight and position it. Now you see that we have some god rays. With volumetrics you can create, for example, effects like fog, haze or god rays. The volumetrics are calculated using voxels. Let's go over all the values here. Here you can change the resolution of the voxel grid in X, Y and Z direction. Most of the time you have to increase the Z value to get a good result, since Z corresponds to the distance from the camera. With the subdivisions, you can control the quality and the performance. More subdivisions will take a longer render time since they are multiplied with the resolution X, Y, Z. With the density scale you can set the density that affects every volumetric object. The temporal jitter radius can reduce artifacts if the resolution of the voxel grid is too low. Before we move on to the Uranda volume object, let me remind you again where you can find the volumetrics far clipping. You can find it here in the camera tag. Make sure to set your far clipping as close as possible and also adjust your near clipping. It could cut off the god rays, for example. In the dashboard you can enable live mode anti-aliasing and change the temporal blend factor. This factor only affects the live view and blends a certain amount of former frames with the actual frames volumetrics. You can choose between a layered or cube volume object. The layered volume mode creates an infinite volume with a gradient. The media AB blend range defines the distance of the falloff between media A and media B. Here you can change density and phase for media A and media B. The density defines how strong the light is scattered. More density means more visible volumetrics. With the phase, you can adjust the light to be more scattered backwards towards the light or if the light is passing forward through the media. If needed, you can clip the layer volume with the clip range. Now changing to cube volume mode, it generates a volume inside the boundaries of a cube. The same applies here. With the size, you can define the size of the volume cube in XYZ. Next type is the noise. With this you can add a noise for the density of the volume object. First you are going to enable noise. You can choose between different noise spaces, world, object and custom. I will quickly show you by creating a null. Put it inside of here and change the position to your liking. If you use world mode, the volume object can be positioned, rotated, scaled without affecting the noise itself. You can also use a curve to define the density of the volume by using density gradient. Octaves control the amount of details the noise will have. Higher number means more detailed noise. Lacunarity works as a multiplier and also increases the detail by maintaining the main shape of the octaves. Persistence works as a multiplier, how quickly the frequency of the noise increases for each octave. With this scale, you can set the global scale of the noise. You can animate the noise itself with the animation speed. But this has no specific direction. Under the movement animation you can change the orientation. Object for example moves the noise depending on the volume object position. World moves the noise in world position. Here you can change the movement direction and speed in all directions, X, Y and Z. The speed acts as a multiplier for the movement values. The adjustments control the density distribution of the noise, can be used in addition to the density gradient. There are a few settings in the light tag. Enable mesh shadows needs to be activated if mesh should cast shadows into volumetrix. Apply a color so the shadow is colorized, and with enable volumetric shadow, volumetrix can cast shadows on itself and on geometry. Here you can adjust the resolution and the subdivisions. Sometimes you have to adjust the volumetric shadow range, which you can do here. That's it for this video. Check out our real-time volumetric rendering overview on our channel for a more detailed video about volumetrics. U-Render is a true real-time rendering software that permits you to achieve immediate noise-free rendering results in full resolution. Hope you liked this video, thanks for watching and see you in the last video.